Assalamu alaikum dear students, I hope you are all fine and doing good. My name is Nurul Ikra and today I am here to deliver the lecture on week 7th task for computer science. The topic for this week is transistors and circuits. Alright dear students, let's begin with determining the objective for this week's lesson. You all will be able to understand the features of the second generation computers by the end of this lecture. Also, students will be able to understand the features of third generation of computers. First of all, dear students, we are going to discuss the second generation computers. Their period of time was from 1956 till 1963. Dear students, the image in front of you is actually one of the computers from the second generation. This is a second generation transistor computer, as the technology that was used in it was containing transistors. It was developed in 1960s and was sold for around $2.9 million. Dear students, what you people need to remember is that the technology that was being introduced in the second generation of computers was of the transistors. Now we need to understand that what transistors are. The second generation of computers began with the discovery of a transistor. What is a transistor? Transistor is a small electronic switch with a very low cost and a long life. Transistors replaced vacuum tubes, increasing the reliability of computers. The size of computers was reduced significantly. They used less electricity, but the computer speed and the data processing capabilities were increased. Alright dear students, now in this image you can see how the transistors look like. The transistors were invented in 1947 but were used in late 1950s. It was far superior to the vacuum tube. Now do you remember what the vacuum tubes are? Yes, vacuum tubes were the technology that was used in the first generation computers. And hence it made the computers to become smaller, faster and cheaper. Now beta, the thing that you need to remember is ki hamari first generation of computers mein jo technology used hui thi wo vacuum tubes thi, theek hai, aur jo second generation mein hamari technology use ho rahi hai jo hum abhi discuss kar rahe hain, that is transistors. Please do remember this point. Coming to the features of second generation of computers. Now period of time was from 1956 till 1963. Size, a big reduction in size as compared to first generation. Like comparing to the first generation, the size was quite reduced. As you can see in the picture that I have earlier shared, even in that picture you can see the computer was very big in size. But right now we are comparing it with the first generation computer. तो उसके कंपैरिजन में बेटा हम ये कह रहे हैं कि उसके कंपैरिजन में जो सेकेंड जनरेशन का कंप्यूटर था वो थोड़ा सा साइज में स्मॉल हो गया था. देन कमिंग टू एनर्जी, लो पावर कंजम्पशन, देन कॉस्ट, कॉस्ट इज अगेन वेरी हाई, स्पीड वॉज फास्टर देन द फर्स्ट जनरेशन कंप्यूटर. एज फार एज रिलायबिलिटी इज कंसर्न्ड, significant improvement was made to make sure that the computers of the second generation were reliable. And examples for the computers are IBM 7090 and TX0. Now coming to the second topic for this week, it is the third generation computers. The time period is from 1964 till 1970. Now let me share the image first so that you have a clear picture in your mind about how these computers look like. Now this image is one of the computers from the third generation of computers. Now you can see the size has reduced from the second generation, but still it looks quite big in size. Now let us discuss the technology that was used in the third generation of computers, and that technology was integrated circuits. Third generation computers appeared with the invention and construction of the integrated circuits, which are many transistors connected together. An integrated circuit is a single piece of material that contains dozens, hundreds, or even millions of transistors connected together. That means कि integrated circuits क्या technology थी कि जो second generation of computers जहाँ transistors use हो रहे थे, अब third generation of computers में ज़्यादा सारे transistors को आपस में interlinked और आप कह सकते हो कि interconnect कर दिया गया, ठीक है? They could be dozens, they could be hundreds, or they could be millions, ठीक है? तो जो third generation की technology थी, उनमें बहुत सारे circuits को बनाने के लिए ट्रांजिस्टर्स को बहुत सारे ट्रांजिस्टर्स को आपस में इंटरकनेक्ट कर दिया गया जस्ट टू फॉर्म एन इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. नाउ द इमेज दैट यू कैन सी इज ऑफ द इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट. इस इंटीग्रेटेड सर्किट के इनसाइड बहुत से ट्रांजिस्टर्स इंटरकनेक्टेड हैं, हेंस दे हैव इंक्रीज्ड स्पीड एज वेल एज द एफिशिएंसी एंड साइज एंड कॉस्ट में रिडक्शन आ गई. Features of third generation computers. Its time period was from 1964 till 1970. The technology that was used in third generation computers was of integrated circuits. Now the size was even smaller from the ones that were already in use. Energy, again, less electricity consumption thinki. For cost, less than second generation computers. Now cost was even reduced. Speed was even faster from the second generation computers. An example is IBM 360. Now at the end, let's quickly recap the concept that we have just understood till now. We have read about three of the generations: the first generation of computers, the second generation of computers, and the third generation of computers. And what you need to remember is that which technology was used in which of these generations. Like, in the very first generation of computers, the technology used was of vacuum tubes. Please repeat after me. The technology used in the first generation computers were vacuum tubes. Then, the technology used in the second generation computers was transistors. The technology used in the second generation computers was, yes, it was transistors. And finally, the technology of integrated circuits was used in third generation of computers. My dear students, I hope that you have understood the concept very well. Thank you so much.